Therefore, the affirmative will call for several points. We'll base the call on several points. First are that the Guantanamo Bay prison is inefficient as a way of deterring terrorists. Secondly, its own existence is illegal as it does not reside on U.S. soil. Third point is that there's lots of human rights violations going on and suspects are not treated humanely. And the fourth argument is that it imposes a burden on the U.S. And the U.S. Regime itself. So starting by the inefficiency of Guantanamo Bay prison, is that from 2002 until now, it has detained approximately 800 detainees, according to the New York Times in 2012, sorry. From all of those 800 detainees, 620 were released because after the trials, which came very, very late after the detention of approximately 7 years, they were found out to be innocent because there are not enough evidence linking them to terrorism. And according to another statistic done by The Guardian in 2011, about 70% of those people happened just to be in the wrong place at the wrong time and did not have any direct connections with Al-Qaeda or Taliban. Second point, the Guantanamo Bay prison is a financial burden on the U.S. As according to Reuters, in 2009, it has cost the U.S. administration, according to a White House spokesman, about the double amount of annual expenses as any other U.S. prison, of approximately $150 million, not to mention the other costs of $500 million in renovations, which is an extra payment for the taxpayers, which not all of them are agreed to the existence of Guantanamo because, according to our third point, it's inhumane in dealing with the detainees. In Guantanamo Bay prison, the habeas corpus right of detainees is not always given, and if so, it's given after a long time of political imprisonment without giving any charge, leaving the suspects or the alleged terrorists lost and very insecure as they do not know their charges or why they are arrested or how long they will stay there, which in many cases, for example, in most cases, stands for many years. Also, the U.S. uses torture on most of, actually all of those prisoners, including waterboarding and beating and psychological torture of insulting their religious beliefs and abusing the Quran, which leaves very deep scars in the detainees that even when they are released, they do not integrate quickly back into society because they have been harmed. And this creates a recruitment tool by terrorist organizations such as Al-Qaeda, because it uses the excuse provided by the U.S. itself by torturing those innocent people to recruit other foreign or other fighters to fight against the U.S. And another point is that the U.S. building Guantanamo Bay prison is illegal, because it was built on Cuban soil. It's the only prison that is not built on the U.S. soil. And this violates the Cuban-American Treaty of 1905, in which it was signed by the President Theodore Roosevelt. And the second article stated that the U.S. will only use the Guantanamo Bay area and the water surrounding it for mining for coal and as a naval station and for those purposes only. So by building a detention camp, actually a prison with many camps over it, it is violating the second article. And therefore, violating the treatment in which provided the land it was built on. Therefore, according to law, it should be closed down for just for its geographical location. I would like to sum up the main points we have given. Is that Guantanamo Bay prison acts as a detention camp for the U.S.'s bullying other countries because it declared itself as the police officer of the world that should go and collect all the terrorists which many of them have been proven to be innocent, and they are treated inhumanely, and much of their rights have been violated, and it's costing the US so much money, and its own existence is illegal. Thank you. They have to be offered. They should be offered to the jurisdictional system. They should be trialed, and depending on the verdict the judges give, they should be either released or moved to another prison to serve their sentences.
Okay. And what if Guantanamo Bay will be closed, and there will be some terrorists who will have a good lawyer? And he will be cleared of all charges.
All of the detainees in the Guantanamo Bay prison have been classified as terrorists due to the US standards. The US standards of terrorists are very flexible, and they can shape themselves around anyone the US finds as a nemesis to their system or just fighting for the country's freedom. So, and especially with their lawyers, they do not always win the cases because they are offered to military trials and not to civil trials. So some cases they end up signing on declarations in their own not in their own language before they are offered to a lawyer. So they give away their right of trial.
Okay, and shouldn't be there attacks after closing Guantanamo Bay, like attacks of terrorists? Attacks in the New York City, for example, because of closing Guantanamo Bay.
Like terrorists going around in the U.S.
Yes.
But the U.S. The Council of Senators passed 6 legislations preventing Guantanamo Bay prisoners from being in U.S. soil.
But
therefore,
they must be somewhere. And
of course, they have their own countries as well.
No, they don't want them.
Who said
that? You will see. Is it for you more important to have more money, as you say, because you say it's expensive, like in Guantanamo Bay, or protection of people's lives?
The US government spends 52% of its annual budget on military and security issues. I doubt that, and only 17% in total on education and infrastructure development and such. So I believe that if this money that's going to the military, which is a lot, goes into other sections, the people will be more aware and of the terrorist declaration they're calling, because those people are not a threat to the US people. Many of the detainees are only children that have been arrested for yelling Allahu Akbar
in front of
church. Yes.
But we think that Guantanamo Bay is definitely not inefficient, as the affirmative says. We have results when the information was released. Plus, we keep those terrorists away from civilians, which is more effective as having them in country. As Alan Dershowitz, a jurist, said, have argued that regulated torture may be the only way to protect Americans. Their second argument was that it's a financial burden. Even if it might be a financial burden, we think that Americans would rather pay to help this day as being in danger, and that is important. The third argument was that humans are treated inhumanly in this way, but they are, according to us, they are very well treated there, they are well fed, they got everything they could possibly want. There isn't any other nation in the world that would provide them with such comfort. And US, on the other hand, doesn't use such methods that would cause such harm as permanent damage to vital organs or permanent emotional trauma. The fourth argument was that the US is illegal, that this way is illegal. But even if it is a law-free zone, we are strongly against the argument that it is illegal, because such as people are not under the, any Geneva Convention, because they are not prisoners of war, they are illegal enemy combatants. And now I would like to bring up our arguments and show you that why you should vote for the negative team. So our first argument why Guantanamo Bay should not be closed immediately is that it is prevention of potential attack. Guantanamo Bay should not be closed immediately because it would cause attack on the Americans. That is what we need Americans protected from. If Guantanamo is closed, then all of its detainees, around 200, will have to be placed somewhere immediately. Since their host countries won't get them back, America is responsible to put them into their own country. And here we see that Americans are in danger. What will then happen is that all of these detainees will be allowed in the US federal card system. And this is a real problem, because if they are once in federal card system, they will have a chance to call for a lawyer that would set them free. And we cannot be sure whether the wrong person is not set free. What happened when they are declared innocent? They will be set free onto the streets of America. Ladies and gentlemen, can you tell me just one New Yorker who would like such ending? Once free, they will find their way how to attack the US. For example, This also happens in the world. Let's look at the case of Abdul Meshul. He was captured in Afghanistan. Then he was transported at Guantanamo. He was there for 2 years. After he was set free, he kidnapped two Chinese engineers and killed one of them. The engineers were working on a hydroelectric dam. So there are why we should protect these Americans. If we see that this could happen, we can't afford to set these detainees free. If once this bay is closed, they will have to be transported into the US, where they can call for a lawyer, as I said, and then, and once they will go free, they will surely try to attack or kill somebody. We cannot forget that they are terrorists whose only will is revenge. Therefore, in order to protect US citizens, Guantanamo Bay shouldn't be closed down. We have to take care of the Americans, and we cannot risk that such harm will happen. And our second argument is getting information for social security. Ladies and gentlemen, Guantanamo Bay served as a prison for many terrorists that already engaged in terrorism against Americans. They are the ones who have the information that can help us to stop this terrorist attack. If we have methods and if we have a prison when we can try and get information that would protect the Americans, then it should not be closed down. For example, Khalid Mohammed, who was also held in the prison, was interrogated, and finally he released the important information that broke up a plot to attack Liberty Tower in LA in 2002. Ladies and gentlemen, without such prison, we would never get such information that would prevent such attack as the Liberty Tower that was planned. Moreover, if this prison was closed, we will never know who exactly will be set free. And if such prison is really effective, then we cannot close it down because it helped the society and it protected the Americans. And therefore, Guantanamo Bay, according to us, should not be closed down immediately. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm open to your questions.
30-second notice, please.
أمريكا هي دائما تحت خطر أنها تكون تعبت لأنه في كثير تيرورست بس لا تنسى كنترول ترميت بالحياة عشان رح نحكي عن عشان اوكي احنا هاي المشكله مش مع انه نفتح كلمه المشكله مع انه نكون شفافين
وليش ليش يعني بس
مش قادرين نحكي العالم لا ما تحكي الناس مش عن جد تعالي عندك اشتغل بس
are you aware that not all the prisoners in Guantanamo
have been proven to be guilty, and a lot of them are just suspects.
I am aware of it, but we have a suspicion that they can be potential terrorists or they were engaged in the terrorist activity.
Seriously?
And this is, I think, the strong reason that why we should do...
Alright, I get your point. So you're saying that it is okay to imprison any suspected person? Any suspected terrorist?
If there are terrorists, yes.
They're suspected to be terrorists.
Okay. I think it's still good when you can get the information, or when you will. If 80% of them are terrorists, then we should do this. Because we still have a chance to protect the Americans. If we don't have this way, how will we?
Why can't this be done outside Guantanamo and in normal U.S. prisons?
This can be done in the U.S. prison because Guantanamo is the one that is law-free. U.S. is not law-free.
So the law is bad.
Law-free zone.
Thank you.
You say that it's very important to hold these detainees in order to extract information from them, and that it's important that this information will help the national security of America. How can you say that when a lot of, as I said earlier, a lot of the detainees were not proven to be terrorists? I think it's completely against human rights to say that. Also, another one of the examples stated was that the American people in themselves would prefer having torture used over the terrorists in Guantanamo Bay over other people, over like having a terrorist attack happening in their country. Well, I would like to say that you also contradicted yourself during saying that, because at the same time you said later that they were treated very well. So I would like to now go to a few of our arguments. Firstly, I would like to reiterate the argument that my colleague Faye said, the efficiency of Guantanamo. Since they are merely suspects, as I stated earlier, there is no way to prevent them from having feelings of strong resentment towards America. Okay? So keeping these people who previously probably didn't have an opinion about that nation, keeping them in detainment and treating them so inhumanely, how would that make them feel, and how would it make their environments feel, how would it make their mothers feel, how would it make their families feel about America? This will create a cycle of violence, which we will return to later on in the debate, naturally. The cycle of violence is created because these people are treated so badly. Next, I would like to refer to the superiority of the American people, or the claim of superiority. They act as though they are superior. Well, breaking international law like that and placing prisoners in a prison like that and not facing the consequences like any other poor, perhaps, nation would, proves that America thinks that they are superior.
Two minutes.
Hi.
organization plans how to reach the people on every mission. So I want to do it to now. It's not to do it to get much and I can make it. The clash points. عندي لا عندي ضمان تقدر تشوف تحكي كل مرة صار لي أي ضمان كنا بحكي أمي بدل بيجي كارتا
does not allow that.
He would like to hello.
Important. So sources of this information, and thanks to them, we can save millions of innocent lives, because if we find out, for example, who is helping with organizing the attacks, etc., we can predict them and help innocent people, what is also our value, security of Americans, and we want to protect them. So that's why we think Guantanamo Bay shouldn't be closed immediately. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Hafa.
We got 5 minutes and 10 seconds.
50 seconds, please.
Thank you.
You said that if Guantanamo Bay prison is closed, they have nowhere to go besides the US, is that right?
Yes.
Now, are you aware that there are over 1,000 military bases for the US with detention facilities?
In US or?
Outside US territory.
But it is proven that the countries of origin won't can take them.
So, do you know that many detainees in Guantanamo were held in secret U.S. prisons in Afghanistan and in a hard detention camp before being transferred to Guantanamo?
Okay, but if they will go to some other prison outside the U.S., they can be danger for those people, those citizens of that state.
So I'm saying that everyone that the US detained was a terrorist, and then they were trying to prove it by using torture.
No, I didn't say that everyone in Guantanamo Bay is terrorist.
And why should we use torture on everyone before making at least small confirmations?
We shouldn't, but we shouldn't also close the Guantanamo Bay, because some of these prisoners are terrorists. We must find some other solution for innocent people.
But what about the innocent people that were the 7 Algerians that were abducted in Sarajevo? They are US troops abducted them and sent them to Guantanamo. After 7 years, they were released, right? And after that, there was no compensation. How are you making sure that if Guantanamo stays open, more innocent people will come and will be detained and tortured?
But I thought we must find other solution for it. But we can't close this Guantanamo Bay prison because many terrorists are there. And
what is the terrorist the US trying to claim? Who falls under the category of terrorist?
Somebody who killed people.
Then what about the non-governmental organization workers that were abducted in Sarajevo? What about Omar Bouteflika that was arrested in Afghanistan? He was 12 years old. Is that a terrorist?
I don't understand you.
I'm saying about children that non-adults that were abducted. Are those terrorists? Minors, are they aware of their own actions? Should be they treated as another person?
If that person killed many people is committing terrorist attacks, so it must be terrorist.
Then when 620 people were released out of 800 that were arrested because they do not have enough charges. Huh? So you didn't see the warning.
From the prisoners
to help protect American civilians. However, this valuable information can be collected in any other ways and in normal US prisons. The fifth clash point was that the negative team assumed that all of the prisoners in Guantanamo Bay are proven to be guilty. However, as my colleagues already stated, most of the prisoners in Guantanamo Bay detention camp have been proven to be innocent. Additionally, they said that there should be trials. The prisoners should be tried. However, according to the policy of Guantanamo Bay detention camp, prisoners are not allowed to be tried in US courts or in any courts at all. Therefore, the negative team has failed to prove this point and provide evidence to prove their point. The eighth point is that we did not say that we would set the prisoners free. All we said is that we give them their human rights and their civil rights. No person should be imprisoned in Guantanamo Bay or any other prison without being proven to be guilty and without having the right to trial. Now, I would like to go over our arguments very quickly. Our argument about the inefficiency of Guantanamo Bay. Guantanamo Bay prison is inefficient because, first of all, it creates the cycle of violence. When prisoners there are tortured or deprived of their human rights, it's very normal to have the counter effect of violence, where they become violent and their families become violent. And this violence would be a danger to the US and to the whole world. Additionally, the negative team disregarded our argument about Guantanamo Bay being illegal. Guantanamo Bay does, in fact, break many policies and treaties, most importantly, the American-Cuban Treaty, which states that America cannot use Guantanamo Bay as a detention camp. The existence of Guantanamo Bay proves the superior attitude of America to the rest of the world's countries, because the existence of this detention camp expresses the superior attitude of the US in many different aspects. First, the US is not given the role of the international police and has no right to collect terrorists from all over the world and put them in prisons. Secondly, the US does not have the right to detain suspects who have not yet been proven to be guilty. Additionally, the suspects are not considered a potential threat. Therefore, the affirmative team says that Guantanamo Bay prison should be immediately closed because it is immoral, unethical, and illegal. Thank you.
Thank you.
250 prisoners, which consists also of dangerous terrorists who would kill millions of people and attack someone. Most of the detainees' countries will not take them back, as we know, from securing liberty. And the location is the difficult question, because we can be persuaded that they will be free and cleared of charges. The Bush administration claims that about 80 would be criminally tried, and if we cannot try the remaining 170, must we release them, or what will be with them? And when we release them, what will be the benefits? There will be no, there will be just the harms. Yes, as affirmative team said, yes, there are also innocent people, and not everyone is a terrorist. And we want to do something with that, of course, but we know that it's not fair and it's bad. But closing Guantanamo isn't a solution for this. We need, there should be some trial of something like that. Because when we close the Guantanamo Bay, there will be free innocent people, yes, that's all right. But there will be also free the killers, the terrorists. We need some compromise with which will claim that the innocent people will be free, but terrorists will stay in Guantanamo Bay. As we know, the terrorists could again commit attacks which could kill millions of innocent people, and it's our moral duty to save the people and to protect the citizens. Terrorists could be clear of charges because of, for example, a good lawyer, and they could get a freedom. And the closing Guantanamo Bay give us only just the harms. First harm will be, after closing Guantanamo Bay, there will be problem with relocation, what is a really important problem and what is a really difficult problem. And second, after closing Guantanamo Bay, there should be a dangerous terrorist in the streets, cleared of charges and causing next attacks. As we know, Guantanamo Bay also uses an effective methods to getting an information like torture. Affirmative team said that it is inhuman, it is cruel and degrading. But what are the people who kill our friends and families? Aren't they inhuman? They are also inhuman. So we need to protect. We need to protect the citizens. So we need to use also like this method. We never say that these methods are not cruel. Yes, they are cruel. But cruel are also the people which kill our friends and families and millions of innocent people. We gave you an example where did it work and where we get an important information will help us with the prevention of potential attack. Even the Guantanamo Bay will be closed, we lost a lot of important information which could prevent us of potential attacks, and it should protect Americans, which is what is our main value. And it's our duty to protect Americans, and it's our duty to protect all citizens and to protect innocent people. And we think that the Guantanamo Bay is a good tool for that. As affirmative team said, there are after closing we can put it to the prisons, for example, in America. But there are no prisons in U.S. where torture is used. And if we close Guantanamo Bay, we cannot use these methods because U.S. is not a lawful zone as a Guantanamo Bay. And if we cannot do torture, we lost a lot of important information. Affirmative team also told us that Guantanamo Bay is expensive. Yes, we know it's expensive, but what is the most important? Financials of America or security of citizens or security of innocent lives. We need that protection of million lives is more important than money, than everything. So Guantanamo Bay, we think that Guantanamo Bay shouldn't be closed down immediately. Please vote for.
Thank you very much. I got the floor at your hand. This is a closed round, so we won't be giving you the decision or any feedback. You guys can give back to
So just take care of stuff.